Hi friends, in today class we will discuss about some of previous gate questions regarding to DC distribution and also our DC or AC distribution and also on bus impedance matrix and also on per unit system. Okay, now open a PDF file on this distribution systems, bus impedance matrix, that is Z bus and per unit system. Okay, now see first question. A single phase AC distributor supplies two single phase loads as shown in figure. The voltage drop from A to C is asking. So as given, the distribution system is given like this. So this is a distribution system which is of AC distribution system. So it is 30 amperes 0.8 power factor lag load. Now she has given a load, another load which is of 40 amperes unity power factor load. Okay, so as given this A, this B and C nodes. So resistance between, resistance of distributor between B and C is 0 plus J 0.35 ohms. Now the distributor A and B having an impedance of J 0.25 ohms. Okay, so as given sending end voltage at A will be 230 volts. Now it's asking what is the voltage drop from A to C. So here we need to find out voltage drop from A to C. V, A, C we need to find out. So for finding voltage drop from A to C, here we need to require, first step we need to take sectional resistances. Sectional resistance we already find. Okay. So if I want to find out voltage drop V, A, C equal to, it is V voltage drop in A, B plus voltage on BC sections. Sum of voltage drop in AB section, BC section. So it is voltage drop in AB section is equal to current into some Z. Impedance of AB section. So BC section is current into impedance of this BC section. So as given, as directly given impedances of these two sections as given. So here I want to find out current in AB section, current in BC section. So try to make the current in this one. So it is unity power factor low, current in this section is equal to same or not. So it is 40 at an angle 0 degrees, right? It's 40 amperes, an angle unity power factor load means cos phi is 1, phase angle phi should be 0, cos 0 is 1. Now see, the current in this section will be what? This current plus this one. Since this is lagging load carrying a current of, say it as I1, 30 at an angle minus cos inverse of 0.8, so it will be of amperes, 30 at an angle of minus 36.86 degrees amperes. So this is the current I1. Suppose say this current I2 which is of current in BC section. Okay, now this current will be what? Sum of these two currents, right? So it will be of I1 plus I2. So if you want to find out voltage drop from A to C, is equal to current in AB section is what? I1 plus I2 which is 30 at an angle minus 36.86 plus 40 at an angle 0 into resistance of in AB section impedance will be J0.25. Since it is AC distributor, we have to consider the magnitude as well as phase angle also. Okay, next, plus voltage drop in BC section will be, it is 40 at an angle 0 degrees into resistance of this section will be J0.25. Okay. J0.35. So after this calculation you are getting voltage drop from A to C. Here you are getting 30.34 at an angle 80.468 amperes. So if he is asking voltage drop from A to C in magnitude 30.34 volts, nearly 30 volts is asked. Okay, answer will be C. Next. Second question. A DC distribution system is shown in figure with a load currents as marked. The two ends of the feeder, are fed by a voltage source S, so that Vp minus Vq is equal to 3 volts. The value of voltage Vp for the minimum voltage of 220 volts at any point on the feeder is. In second question is asking means what? Second question is related to what? So the feed, the loads are feeding by both sides. Means it is what? Ringman distributor is given. So it is given Ringman distributor like this. This is a Ringman distributor as given. So this is P, this is Q. This is voltage Vp, this is a voltage Vq at both ends. So here the loads are tapped here like this. Okay. Like this. So it is 10 amperes. So it is 20 amperes, 30 amperes and 15 amperes. As given this is P, this is Q, this is R, this is S. Now see, he has given resistance of the sections, which one will be 0.1 ohm. So 0.15 ohm, it is 0.2 ohm is given. Now he is asking, what is the value of voltage Vp? What is the voltage of Vp for which the minimum voltage of 220 volts at any point on this distributor is 220 volts. So minimum voltage at any point on the distributor means at Vp, Vr or Vs or Vq maybe is given as 220 volts is given. Then is asking find the value of Vp. So if you want to solve these type of questions means if the loads are fed by two sides, then I have given a procedure. So take current from any one of the source. So here I am taking current from source P, Vp. So just take current I1. This current is flowing in up to here. So current in this section PR will be what? I1 minus 10. This I1 minus 30. Current in this section will be I1 minus, it is what? I1 minus 60 amperes. Here it is I1 minus 75 amperes. Like this. First we need to take IA from VA or take I1 from VP. Then find the sectional currents. In this section will be I1 minus 10, I1 minus 30, I1 minus 60, I1 minus 75. Okay. So it is. Next apply KVL. Next third step is apply KVL. Find the current I1. So if I apply KVL means you got by applying KVL for the loop. So it is Vp is equal to this drop plus this drop plus this drop plus Vq, right? So it will be equal to Vpr, voltage drop in this section Pr, voltage drop in this section Rs, voltage drop in section Sq plus Vq. Okay, this is rise, drop, rise. Okay, next. Voltage drop in this section will be equal to what? Current into this resistance. Voltage drop in PR section will be current into this resistance. It's I1 in minus 10 into 0.15, 0.1 plus I1 minus 30 into 0.15 plus I1 minus 60 into 0.2. Is equal to what? Vp minus Vq. Here I am moving this one to this side. As given Vp minus Vq is how much? 3 is equal to. So find out, calculate this one. Simplify this equation. So it is what? I1 if I take common 0.1 plus 0.15 plus 0.2 minus 1 minus 4.5 minus 4.5. Minus 6. Sorry, it is 12. It is 12. So if you calculate this one, find out the value of I1, we are getting 45.55 amperes. So find out the sectional currents here. If it is sectional current, current in section PR is equal to what? I1 minus 10. So it will be 45 minus 55 is current I1. It is what? 35.55 amperes. Now in this section current will be what? It is 5.55 amperes. Now in this section current will be, so I1 minus 60. So it is 5 minus 60. 5 5.55 minus 60 it is 45.45 amperes. 45.45 amperes. Okay. So you are getting what? Negative or not? Negative current. Suppose if you are getting negative current means this value is negative current in this section. So this node, at this node we are getting negative voltage. So we are getting current in at point S will be negative. So current in this section is SQ will be negative. So here at this node we are getting minimum node potential. So at node S we are getting minimum potential. Minimum potential is obtained. So has given minimum voltage at any point. So this is what voltage at node S is given. How much? 220 volts is given. Now find out VP. Has given voltage at node S is equal to 220 volts. Then find VP. So apply KVL. So this VP is equal to voltage drop in PR section, voltage drop in QS section plus AVS. Okay. So VP is equal to voltage drop in PR section will be what? Current into means 35.55 into 0.1 plus it is 5.55 into 0.15 plus 220 will give you the voltage at the sending end VP. Okay. So VP is equal to this draw plus VS, node voltage 220 volts. Then we are getting this one as 225.89 volts. 225.89 volts you are getting. Okay. Next. The fifth question. Try to do the fifth question. Fifth question. So as given a single line diagram of a 4 bus single system, single source distribution system is shown below. The branches E1, E2, E3, E4 have equal impedances. The load current values are indicated in the figure or in per unit. The distribution company's policy requires radial distribution operation with a minimum loss. So this can be achieved by opening of the branches. So from ring main system we have to make the radial distribution. Radial distribution number of wires are less. The losses will be very very less when compared to ring main distribution. So as given ring main distribution having a configuration of distribution system is like this. Configuration of distribution system is given like this. Okay. So it is what? Is E1, is E2, E3. It is E3 and E4. So load drawn at this one will be 1 plus J0. This per unit has given. Okay. So it is what? 2 plus J0 in per unit. But here will be 5 plus J0 per unit. So by opening any one of the branch has to make radial distribution in order to decrease the transmission losses. Which branch has to be eliminated? Means which branch has to be removed? Okay, is asking. Okay. Now see, by opening E1, by opening branch E1. Suppose if I open this branch E1, means, see, this is one current of what? One per unit current is flowing. So current in this branch will be 2 plus 1, 3 per unit. Current in this branch will be 3 plus 5, 8 per unit. Now tell me, find out losses. So losses, transmission line losses is equal to what? I square R. Okay, since R is same, resistance value is always same. So it is I square into R. Current in first section is 8 per unit, E2 section, 8 square into R, plus in this section will be 3 square into R, plus 1 square into R, will give you, so it is 64 plus it is 9 plus 1, so it into 74 R losses. 74 R of watts of losses will occur here. Okay. Now in second case, by opening E2. Now if I open E2, previously we have E1 here, this is E1. Now if I open E2, now what happens? See, it is 5 per unit current is here. It is current in this branch is what? 5 per unit. Current in this branch will be 5 plus 2, 7 per unit. Current in this branch will be 7 plus 1, 8 per unit. Okay. Now make to find transmission line losses. So transmission line losses in this one equal to P loss is equal to, so it is in first section E1 it is 8 square into R plus in this section will be 7 square into R. Okay. So next plus this section will be 5 square into R. So if you calculate this one you are getting 138 into R. Now, third one, by opening E3, if I open E3 branch, previously I have E2 here, okay, now if I open E3, we'll see now. So this is 1 per unit current. So it is 1 per unit current is here like this. In this branch the current is what? 2 per unit. So current will flows like this, 2 per unit. Now in this branch current will be 2 plus 5, 7 per unit of current. Now try to make transmission line losses by opening branch E3. So transmission line losses is equal to branch E1 will be current is I square into R, 1 per unit of current. So in second branch E2, branch E2, 7 square into R. Now similarly for E4 branch it is 2 square into R. So it is 54 into R you got. 54 into R of transmission line losses. Now last one, by opening branch E4. Now if I open branch E4, previously we have E3. Now if I open branch E4, now we'll see the transmission line losses. So see, if I open this one E4, current in this section will be 5 per unit. Current in this section E3 will be what? 2 per unit. Now current in E1 section will be 2 plus 1, 3 per unit. Now try to make transmission line losses. Transmission line losses is equal to, so in E1 section it is 3 square into R. In E2 section will be 5 square into R. In this section will be 2 square into R. So which will be 9 plus 25 plus 4 into R. Here we are getting 38 into R. If you observe the transmission line losses in 4 cases. So see, this is first case will be, if I open branch E1, transmission loss is 74 R. If I open E2, it is 138 into R. So it is transmission line loss in third case by opening E3 is 54. Transmission line losses by opening E4 will be 38 into R. So in fourth case, if I open the branch E4, transmission line losses are very very less. So this method is easy for radial transmission loss. Okay, radial transmission for making transmission line loss should be very very less. It is achieved by opening branch E4. Answer will be D. Next. Sixth question you can solve by your own. I will give you a hint for you. Okay. So he has given a just twist in the question. Before asking minimum node voltage, before asking voltage drop in the sections and voltage at the nodes, he is asking contribution of currents. Well, see, a distributed feeder of 1 km length having resistance but negligible reactance. It is fed from the both ends by 400 volts 50 hertz balanced sources. Both voltages S1 and S2 are in phase. The feeder supplies a concentrated loads of unity power factor as shown in figure. So this is see here, circuit diagram is given like this. This distribution system is given. Okay. Having two plants S1 and S2. Voltage of S1 S2 are in phase. Okay. So has tapped three loads here. 200 amperes, 100 amperes, 200 amperes. So it is 400 meters, 200 meters. It is also 200 meters. It is 200 meters. Okay. Next, he has given a point P. He is asking the contribution of S1 and S2 in 100 amperes current supplied at location P respectively are. So at point P he has tapped 100 amperes, right? So what is the contribution of plant S1, generator S1 to the for supplying current and 100 amperes? What is the contribution of S2? How much amount of power supplied by plant S2 for supplying this 100 amperes current? Okay, so take, this is what? Ring main feeder. So we have to take current, any one current from any one of the source. Here I am taking I1 from S1. Find out, second step is sectional currents. So in this section current will be I1, in this section current will be, in this section current will be I1 minus 200, in this section I1 minus 100, in this section I1 minus 500, it is I1 minus 300, it is I1 minus 500 amperes. So after making these sectional currents, we have to find out sectional resistances. So suppose take let, R is the resistance of distributor per kilometer. So it is what, for 1000 meters, resistance of distributor is R ohms. Okay, here I want to find out for 400 meters. For 400 meter resistance will be 400 into R by 1000. So which will be 2R by 5 ohms. Suppose for 200 meters, for 200 meters, it is 200 into R by 1000. R by 1000. So which will be R by 5 ohms. Since it is DC distribution, we have to take 2 into R. Right? So see, now apply KVL. So which will be VS1 minus VS1 is equal to, apply voltage here, VS1 minus VS1 is equal to this drop plus this drop plus this drop plus this drop. Okay. Here we are not getting this one. So which is? So it is I1 into resistance in this section will be 400 meters. It is 2R by 5 plus in this section will be what? I1 minus 200 into R by 5, I1 minus 300 into what? It is R by 5 plus I1 minus 500 into R by 5. So here this distribution we have to take 2 into R. So it is always a 2 into R, we have to take 2. Okay. Since these two voltages are maintaining at constant voltage of 400 volts, it is 0. Is equal to, since it is R by 5, take R by 5 as a common, 2R by 5 as a common, and make this one to this side, you have to make 0. Okay, so here it is 2R by 5. So it is 2I1, 2 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. So it is 5 into I1. Next, so it is 200. 300 means 500 minus 500, it is 1000. So I1 will be how much? 200 amperes. So after finding current I1, find out the sectional currents. Try to make sectional currents. So this current will be 200 amperes. This section current will be 0 ampere. In this section current will be minus 100 ampere. In this current section will be minus. So it is 200 minus 500, it is minus 300 ampere. So if it is, see, current is we are getting negative in which section? This section only. So it is here we are getting minimum node potential point. This is minimum node potential point. Minimum node potential point. Okay. So here it is minimum node potential. So it is current. So this current amperes current is contributed by both S1 and S2. So here we need to find out contribution of S1 for 100 amperes current at P is equal to what? So it is supplying what? 0 amperes, right? It is 0 amperes. Now contribution of S2 for 100 amperes at location P will be, so it is what? Minus 100, which is from S1. So suppose since it is supplying from S2, means it is minus of minus 100, it is 100 amperes of current which is contributed by plant S2. In this way we are finding unknown value of quantity, what is asking. Okay, always follow the same procedure. Take any one of the current from any one of the source, make sectional currents, then after find out sectional resistances, then apply KVL, then find out the value of I1. So after finding this one, find the value of sectional currents and find out the minimum node potential by observing the negative sign. Then after find out what is asking. Is asking node voltage or voltage drop in the section, or is asking contribution of any one of the plant at any particular location. Okay. Next we will see seventh question.